Thank you. And I don't think it's because I am violinist. I think you can play a little bit more in general. Mm-hmm. There are a couple of places where you can come down to let the show through, but we'll go through that later. Let's go from the beginning.
Catch it, you might not catch it. I would just recommend, and you both go like that. You want to try? So you both cue it together. That's good. Now try to sustain that, so that it sounds more like a chord. You know, like you're playing these four notes on the, or three notes on the piano, kind of. To make the sound more sustained. Relax your right arm a little bit more. And feel the weight of your arm and strength. The enemy of producing sound is force. So if you try to make more sound, you'll make less. The other thing, I stay in position here. I don't know if that might be helpful, but to me it feels risky. And if you think dum pum 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 a little bit like that, I think that will also help the balance. Try to put your violin a little bit higher. Okay? You know, like we're producing sound like this, like a singer. You know, singer wouldn't stand like this. So really feel the weight of your arm in the string. The last thing, make sure we hear the. There's a good articulation. No. Okay? Great. More like think baroque in a way. doing a lot, but you're really not doing that much. I feel like you think you're overdoing it, and you're really not at all. Yeah. And also, it feels like you're counting a bit like this, and then it gets slower and slower. It needs to keep rolling and rolling and rolling. You know, it's the same over and over harmony. There needs to be movement in there. Yeah? Do this one more time, and let's go. It's a nice way of breaking it up a little bit of the monotonous, the same over and over. Mm-hmm. Yeah? You want to try it? Last 4 minutes? think each note. Yeah, so she will wait for you to get to the top. There's no danger that she's going to crash in early. I feel very confident about that. So when you play it with legato, think the same way that you played separately. That's too fast. That's better. But when you practice, you know, 15 times. And then do bowing. Okay. If you can catch that, I think that'll work for you too. Try one. Next, take your time. Let's play together once. Same place. So see, that's a lot more time than you think. Okay? Try it together once. It's hard, but you have a really good chemistry, so it will just take a couple of tries, mm-hmm. and then you will get there. But don't be shy about it. And the thing is, when you get here, wait for her. So it might take a little bit longer, it might take a little bit shorter, it's hard to know exactly. But don't go until she has played her first 2 minutes. Okay. Yeah? Should we do where you just started and do the repeat and then go on? But I think we can fix this, yeah? Okay, right there? Try, go from that variation. Second hand, ultra soft and kind of whimsical. Yeah. big machine that takes a really long time to go. Maybe you can think a little smaller machine that's a little bit quicker. I think a little bit of the feeling is good, but I feel like you're overdoing it. Lots of bow, so you get a really ring to your violin. And then you get a really nice contrast. Okay? Good. And I think it actually becomes easier when you think lighter. It becomes less labor. You don't have to work as hard for it. Do you have anything to add?
You like this piece, no? Yes?
Yeah.
Yes, you like it? Good. So what I was thinking when I was listening to you is that I would like to see that more, you know? It happens a lot when you get a little nervous and you're performing that you tend to just kind of retract a little bit. But I would like to see more of that enthusiasm for the piece. I also agreed with David that I want to hear you a little bit more. And also I was sitting on that side, so I probably heard more of you anyways. But I think that, in general, when you play a piece like this that's so powerful, that you really show that with your whole body, really. And that's one of the things that, because I've obviously never played this, I wish I could, I love the piece, but I've heard David play it so many times, and one of the things that he does a lot when he's on stage, like, he really just shows that this is my piece, you know? And I think that is something that you can think about a little bit more when you're performing it. And that goes for everybody, really, when you're on stage. And, you know, for to just kind of take charge of the piece a little bit more. I also wanted to hear a little bit more of the dynamic contrast. So when you have, like, the really soft pianissimos, just really, just like, you can almost not hear it, you know? And that makes it so much more effective, especially when you have those repeats, and then the second time you have a pianissimo, just so quietly and so beautifully. And then lastly, you can communicate a little bit more, I think. You know, right now it seemed like you were just like, oh, this is my part, I'm just gonna stick to it. But in this part, especially with a piece like this, I think that it's important that you just kind of, you look at each other a little bit more, and then, you know, you give her the melody, and then she gives you the melody, and, you know, you can kind of communicate a little bit better like that. It's so important in chamber music that I feel like one of the most important things that I do when I play chamber music is that I almost memorize it so that I can actually look at the other people when I'm performing and playing. But I thought it was really, really beautiful, and just work on those small things and just show the audience that you love the piece a little bit more. But really beautiful job. Well, thank you.